Welcome to LINAK's Actuator Academy video series for industrial actuators. I'm Hunter, and in this episode, we'll talk about clutches, their functionality, and how they work in a linear actuator. An electric linear actuator is built with three primary components: a motor, gearing, and a spindle. These components are typically connected like this. In some cases, a clutch can be included in the actuator design. Let's start by digging into the details of how the clutch mechanism works. The full assembly of the clutch, planetary gear, and DC motor looks like this. The clutch here serves two primary purposes within a linear actuator. First, it protects the actuator itself and the application it has been installed in. But secondly, it also allows the actuator to be used without control electronics, such as current cutoff or a fuse. The clutch makes LINAK's LA36 actuator versatile and easy to implement in different machinery. In the actuator, the clutch is designed to handle a push or pull load of approximately 1.5 to 2 times its rated load at nominal speed before the clutch disengages or slips. The clutch disengages the rotational movement from the motor that is passed to the spindle and the gear. Since the clutch only works while the actuator is moving, if there is a heavy load on the actuator while it is still, the clutch will not act as a safety feature. It only works when the motor is rotating. So that was a bit of information about clutches, including their functionality and purpose in linear actuators. If you have any questions about clutches for electric linear actuators, please feel free to contact your local LINAK office. Thank you so much for watching.